Yo, what is good, YouTube? We're back with another video. If you are not in the free Discord, go join it. It is the first link down below. But I had zero trades today on NQ or the ES, so I'm going to be going over the two trades that I took Monday. One trade on Monday, one trade on Tuesday. So we're going to go over those two trades. One was on gold, one was on NQ. The first one we're going to be going over will be gold because that was the Monday trade. So if you guys watched my weekly analysis video, you guys know I was saying, yeah, we're going to be going to all-time highs on gold. Silver did not reach my draw on liquidity, so now we have this SMT up here. So silver didn't reach those monthly equal highs. Gold, however, did reach these all-time highs. So coming into the day on Monday, if we want to go back to Monday, let's see here. Monday at... we'll go right here. Monday. So Monday, coming into the day, I saw, hey, we have this buy side level here. We held this 4-hour fair value gap and we created another one. So as I was looking at the charts coming into Monday, I saw, yeah, we're probably going to deliver from internal to external. So then I went down to the hourly and saw we have this fair value gap. So now that we have a 4-hour getting bounced out of, and a 1-hour getting bounced out of, this high looked to be the obvious draw on liquidity. So what did I do? Came down to the 15-minute, saw that we were bouncing off this order block right here. Why is this an order block? It got support from this imbalance, and we started to deliver higher. So the next thing I did was go down to this 5-minute chart. Now, what did I do from here? I measured out this manipulation leg. I used this high. Notice that we had two and a half line up perfectly with that buy side. Now, the next thing I did was mark out this fair value gap, changing the state of delivery, and longed inside of this fair value gap. Now, longed here, very simple trade. I had my stop loss one tick below this low. It came within one tick of stopping me out, and then we delivered to this high. So I did put this in Discord that I literally can't gold oil chat. Let's see if I can copy and paste this picture. Came within literally one copy image. Let's see. Yeah. Check it out. Right there. Can you guys see that? Yeah. Right here was my long position inside that fair value gap. You guys can literally see that it's the exact same thing right here. So these two up close candles, these two up close candles right here. Fair value gap, one tick, equal lows. So you guys can see that I came within one tick of getting stopped out here. And then we continued to drive up to those, to this buy side level. So very, very simple trade on gold this week. And like I said, I was only eyeballing for longs because I knew all-time highs were going to be the draw on liquidity. Now, NQ, yesterday. Where? Tuesday, right here. We'll go to here. So, on Tuesday, I did not take anything throughout this price action, anything throughout here, until we get to right here. Now, why did I take a trade here, right? So if we measure out this manipulation move, we can see negative two gets hit, and then we come back down, sweep these lows, and still remain inside of negative two, 2.5. Then we get this move higher. Now I'm still waiting, right? Still waiting, not jumping the gun, not doing anything yet. Right here, when we form this SMT, so we form an SMT with the ES, I was actually on the 15-minute chart. I marked this out as a breaker. Breaker, and went down to the 5-minute, said, hey, we actually have a nice unicorn set up here. Fair value gap breaker, perfect. My first contract, where did I get out of my first contract? I put it in the trading chat. I didn't put it in my chat yesterday, but right here, full execution. So 65 was my first. So I took one off at this high, or relatively close to that high. Actually, we wicked it, so I got out a little lower than this high. And then my last contract, so I got filled two contracts at 30 right here, and then I had one contract off right here, and then I was going to leave a runner to this high up here. So right there. Now when we entered this right here, I was at the gym. So I was at the gym whenever we had this price action happening, right? Obviously I'm in pretty good profit, longed at 30. My stop, as soon as this candle blasted up like this, my stop literally went straight to break even, because after that move I assumed, yeah, we're not coming lower. And my first PT got hit almost instantly. And then obviously up here I'm in pretty good profit, about 50 points. And then when we take this high right here, I just got out of my contract because I was at the gym. I was very impatient because I was lifting. So I was just like, yeah, if we take this high, I'm just going to take it off and not sit through another half hour of this, because I knew at 345 was going to be the time we were most likely going to be taking this high. We took it at 355 because that 345, it opens the end of the day algos move 345. It starts getting pretty volatile. So I was like, yeah, we probably just drive to that high. And then ES, I was waiting for ES to take all-time highs, and I was driving to the gym while I was staring at the ES chart. I was like, dude, come on, just take the high already. But after we just took this high right here, I just took it off. My fill was 87, so I got off right here. Right, wait, how did I get filled at 87 on this candle right here? Oh, so we took the high. Okay, I got filled on this candle right here. But yeah, I was just very impatient after this price action came in. But this trade was 30 to 65, 35 points, 87, 30, 47 points. So whatever that is to dollar value, you guys can do the math. I don't know. But I wonder if standard deviations aligned up here. No, they didn't. But yeah, that was the trade. I wonder if this one does. Nope. But yeah. Two very simple trades. Why didn't I take any trades throughout here? Well, after we got this nice dump, what we were talking about in voice chat was, I was like, yeah, this breaker right here looks really good to short. I just didn't end up taking it because ES at the time, if we go to ES, what time was that? 9:50. ES was the whole way up here. I was like, dude, ES looks like it wants all-time highs, and NQ's just dumping. But as we see today, we did end up hitting the draw on liquidity, right? I said this weekly internal, but we are getting a much bigger move than I originally anticipated coming into the week, right? I said, I just expect this weekly imbalance to get filled, and then we probably return back to all-time highs. But now we have this weekly SMT here, right? NQ doesn't take the high, ES does, so it looks cleaner on the daily probably. Yeah, ES does, and now we just got this massive candle, 590 points so far. And I don't remember seeing NQ be down almost 600 points. I just, like, this candle's pretty big, but it's not 600 points. It's 430. Yeah, I mean, obviously, there might have been a day that, like, I just forget, but there could have been a day where NQ was down 500-600 points. I just don't remember. But yeah, I was not expecting this big of a sell-off coming into the week or coming into the day. Like, coming into today, I was like, well, if we go to the 15-minute, London, we had, like, these highs right here. So I was like, are we going to get up there? Like, ES looked like it wanted to go up there at the beginning. Like, I thought maybe these highs want to get SMT'd, but it was just this high that got SMT'd, right? Not 8:15. 8:15 gets taken, and then we continue lower. So I wanted to see if we were going to go lower. I wanted to see if we could get up to these highs, right? I wasn't sitting on the 1-minute chart today. Like, we had that. I woke up and saw NQB down 300 points. And I was like, yeah, I'm not going to be sitting on the one-minute chart today. I'm going to be waiting to see if we can create some five-minute structure. Obviously, there was some decent short setups. Like, right here, we set up a... it's an ugly unicorn, but right here would be your breaker. Or this candle right here, last swing low before the move higher, taking out these highs. But it's not a clean unicorn. Like, this is not a clean unicorn. ES, however, did have a nice unicorn right here. So, yeah, ES had a nice unicorn, but NQ did not. So, yeah, I mean, we pulled back to OTE right here and then continued the sell-off, right? Even on the, I mean, the one-minute chart, you could have short, I don't know, bro. I didn't want to sit on this one-minute chart. I said, if there's no setup by 10:30, I'm just going to get off the charts. And then my power went out. So after my power went out, I just left the computer. And now it's about 1:15 p.m. So now here I am making this quick YouTube video. And then I don't know if it stops raining and the sun comes out, I'll go swim. But yeah, so join the free Discord if you're not in it. And I'll see you guys in another video. Peace.